Infinite came out in 96. That's his first independent record. So yeah, this has been a minute.
Independent, from an independent record to now, it's interesting how much has changed. When y'all put that out, and I know we're going to talk about what we came to talk about today, but when you put out Infinite, what was the goal? Like, what was your vision?
Well, I wasn't involved yet, actually. He had done that on his own, and I bought Infinite from him on cassette for $6. He was selling them hand-to-hand at the hip-hop shop on 7 Mile. And it took me by surprise, in the sense that I was surprised he had it together so much to be able to put out an independent product. You know, back then that wasn't easy to do. Like, you had to really have your stuff together, right? You had to be able to afford a studio. You had to hire producers. You couldn't just record everything at home and press a button on your computer. You had to send it off to be manufactured and get the cassettes back. And, you know, it was very different back then. So I was impressed by the fact that he had it together and had a group of people that knew enough to be able to put this product into his hands. And then I heard it and I thought it was great. But, you know, if you've heard Infinite, and I know you have, Sway, but maybe some of the audience hasn't, it's very different than the Eminem that you're used to now, and in almost every regard, right? The way he sounded, his delivery, the subject matter, the types of beats, it was all very different than the Eminem that you know today. But the one thing that I heard was the talent, right? So I knew that he had this sort of raw ability to rap it really, really well. So I stayed focused on him and stayed in touch with him after I left Detroit and I moved to New York to take the bar exam. And then some friends reached out to me. It was actually DJ Head, who was Marshall's DJ at one time, reached out to me and said, hey, you got to check out the new stuff Eminem's doing. And so that's when he had the bare bones of what became the Slim Shady EP. So it had like Just Don't Give a Fuck on there, and records like that. And then that's when he found his voice and created Slim Shady, and that attitude that really is his attitude, and gave him this sort of freedom to be who he really is as an artist. And that's when I was like, okay, this is something I'm definitely going to want to work with.